Hello everyone and welcome to my workshop. Is this mini PC in the shape of a single board computer the real Raspberry Pi killer? Today we're going to be taking a look at the Radxa X4, a single board computer with a mini PC brain. This board has an Intel N100 CPU and GPIO pins just like on a Raspberry Pi. During the chip shortage, when buying a Raspberry Pi required notifications from RPi locator to find them in stock, one of the most frequent comments I saw was, "Don't buy a Raspberry Pi, just buy a mini PC." But a mini PC is not a Raspberry Pi. A lot of mini PCs have much higher power usage and they weren't really computers that could be embedded in a project. Like, you can't send a nuke PC up a weather balloon. The Radxa X4 is the single board computer everyone has been asking for in the last 2 years. Is it able to meet the high expectations though? Let's find out. Oh, did I mention the Radxa X4 is the same price as the Pi 5? The 4GB version is $60 and the 8GB version is $80. There's supposedly a 12GB version, but I can't find any pricing information for that. The X4 is not Radxa's first hybrid SBC / mini PC product. Not too long ago, they released the Radxa X2L, which also has GPIO pins, but was equipped with a much older and less performant Intel CPU. I reviewed the X2L in the previous video that you can check out, you know, linked somewhere. Radxa basically shrunk the X2L into a board roughly the same size as a Raspberry Pi and gave it a much better CPU and totally went nuts on the heatsink design. Everyone knows that Raspberry Pi computers are not the fastest machines out there, but they're highly regarded in terms of software support and energy efficiency. Aside from the CPU architecture, there are quite a few differences between the Raspberry Pi 5 and the Radxa X4. So what makes a single board computer a single board computer? Some people might say it's the GPIO pins, right? And the GPIO on the Radxa X4 is driven by a Raspberry Pi RP2040 chip. So right, this SBC has a Raspberry Pi chip on it. See, there are two sides to this single board computer. There's the computer side and there's the microcontroller side. Everyone familiar with the Pi Pico platform will feel right at home here. There's only one complicated factor though. You don't have direct access to the GPIO from the computer side of things. On the X4, when you push a button connected to GPIO, the command first needs to go to the microcontroller side of things, and then the RP2040 needs to send a serial signal to the computer side of things. I have a blog post link in the description below where I go over how to get this communication flowing between the RP2040 chip and the Intel chip. And just to be clear, the X4 is not compatible with Raspberry Pi HATs. How the GPIO works is not the only difference between the Radxa X4 and a Raspberry Pi. Starting with their size, the Radxa X4 would be the same size as a Raspberry Pi if it wasn't for this little bump on the side of the board. I guess they ran out of board space and couldn't use through-hole headers. With the surface mount headers, they were able to use the underside of the board for more components. Another difference is that on an ARM SBC, the OS needs to be tailored specifically to each board. Since the X4 is an x86 system, you can download pretty much any OS and install it on this board. Even Windows works on the X4 if that's your thing. Finding drivers for hardware is a lot easier on an x86 system. Who hasn't dealt with the frustration of finally finding a Linux driver for a piece of hardware you really want to get working, only to realize that you don't have an ARM version of the Linux driver? Yeah, I'm looking at you, shipping label printer. The Raspberry Pi needs an expansion board to allow you to use NVMe SSD through PCIe connection. The X4 has an M.2 connector on board directly linked to their PCIe lanes. And did I mention that the Radxa X4 has built-in 2.5 gigabit Ethernet? You usually see 2.5 gigabits on more expensive boards, and it's kind of crazy that for $80, you can have 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. Another main difference is that this little guy consumes a lot more power. And added power comes with added heat, and in this case, a lot of heat. You have to buy this heatsink separately for $15, but I really think this should come included. I guess they wanted to keep the $80 price tag competitive with the Raspberry Pi 5 and decided to package it separately. Without adequate cooling on the N100 chip on this board, it will run much slower and you have a really bad time with performance. One thing to know, the thermal pad comes with the heatsink is really thin and crumbly. I had seen pictures on social media and blog posts where I was extra careful peeling the backing on mine, and it worked okay. You might have noticed that the X4 is missing other features that are common on SBCs, like a specialized camera and display port and the lack of an SD card slot. In a lot of ways, this board is closer to being a mini PC with GPIO than a single board computer. But as computers get smaller and smaller, we're just arguing semantics at this point. But the X4 is not a traditional mini PC either. For instance, it doesn't have additional expansion ports aside from the single M.2 slot, and the top-of-the-line model only has 12 gigs of RAM. Wait a second, 12 gigs? Did I read that right? Yep, I did. This ASRock N100 motherboard has the same Intel chip as the X4, but it's a lot more mini PC-like than the X4. It accepts up to 32 gigabytes of RAM, it has room for a full-size NVMe SSD, and it has plenty of I/O, including two SATA ports. The ASRock Mini PC doesn't have the GPIO header, but I could just as easily connect a $6 Raspberry Pi Pico to a USB port on it, and it would have the exact same GPIO capabilities as the X4. This is a mini ITX motherboard, and although it's pretty small as far as motherboards go, it's still quite a bit bigger than the X4. While I was able to add 32 gigs of RAM to the ASRock board, it cost me quite a bit more than the X4 also. The Radxa X4 has a trick up its sleeve that most mini PCs don't. This board is compatible with PoE, or Power over Ethernet, and Radxa has a HAT designed specifically for it. This is huge for industrial applications where a power outlet might not be available nearby, and you just need one cable to provide power and data. This is also big for home labbers that are running out of slots on their rack power strip, and you know who you are out there. But the PoE implementation on this board is a little kludgy. The main GPIO header on this HAT is passed through, and you would be able to see the HAT properly if Radxa hadn't chosen to include these other connectors for the Ethernet power headers and the connectors that feeds the power into X4. They're not passed through. The pins are too tall for the connections, and they just top out before the HAT is fully seated on the board. I'm also not entirely sure how to secure any HAT to the X4 with the heatsink attached to it. You need to have screws that secure the board to the heatsink, leaving me with no options to secure a HAT to the board. Again, this board needs adequate cooling, so not having a heatsink is not an option. I'm talking about design improvements. The heatsink needs a lot of that. I appreciate that the heatsink and the sled, I'm just going to call this part of the heatsink the sled because it looks like a sled, are separate pieces, and I could design a brand new bottom part for the heatsink, so that's cool. But the sled part of the heatsink has some room for improvement. I'm not sure what these holes on the side of the sled are for. Well, I kind of do actually. I think the holes were meant to be on top of the sled to give you access to the board's mounting holes, which, as you can see here, are blocked by the sled on this side of the board. I think they just messed up the placement of these holes, but that's just me speculating it. And this means that to remove the board from the heatsink, you have to unscrew 10 different screws, and that's just way too many screws. Another issue is that the sled is on top of two of the GPIO pins, and you can't fit a connector with more than, say, like four positions with the sled on. So that's six screws you have to remove every time you want to change GPIO connectors or fit a new hat. I can hear you screaming in the background, "Hey Andre, just don't put the sled." The thing is, this thing is very tippy without the sled. I could leave it upside down, but then the fan gets really choked and super loud. Louder than it already is. And my last comment about the design of the heatsink is about the fan that it comes with. It's a two-wire fan and you can't control the speed. It's either full tilt or full tilt, because you can't turn it off either. This fan is pretty loud and annoying, so I hope to see a redesign in the future. Let's move on and talk about performance. This thing runs laps around the Raspberry Pi 5, performing around 40% better on benchmarks. It's also about 20% faster than the Rockchip 3588, which many people consider today's gold standard for ARM single board computers. Keep in mind that these are just benchmarks, and your mileage may vary based on what you're doing with these boards. As for desktop use, the Radxa X4 is super responsive. This is an area where some single board computers really struggle with. Just browsing the internet is yet another area the ARM SBCs struggle with, sometimes due to lack of graphics acceleration, which doesn't seem to be an issue with the X4. Although you can see a few drop frames here playing 4K 60 YouTube videos, overall performance is great, I have no complaints. The Intel N100 also supports virtualization out of the box, meaning you can install Proxmox on this board and start a tiny home lab. If you're going that route though, I would recommend the 12 gigabit RAM if you can find it, so your virtual machines have some breathing room. But all this performance comes with a cost. Raspberry Pi and most other SBCs of the same generation, like the ROG 5C or the Orange Pi 5, they just sip on 4 watts of power when idling. The Radxa X4 uses 9 watts on idle. When running simulated stress tests, power consumption spiked to 18 watts. And just for reference, top power consumption on an ARM single board computer in the current generation is usually around 9 to 10 watts. The ASRock Mini PC pulls around 12 watts on idle, but that's with 32 gigs of RAM and two SSDs plugged in. Right, so the top power consumption on an ARM SBC like the Raspberry Pi 5 with the CPU at full tilt is the same as the idle power consumption on the Radxa X4. And that's a pretty big consideration. I have a Pi 5 NAS with 2.5 gigabit networking, and I use it for transferring data between computers, and it just sips on 4 watts 99% of the time. The cost of running like a 9 watt appliance might not seem like a lot, but if you have a few of these machines running at the same time, it can add up quickly. If you haven't made it this far in the video, I really appreciate it, and it probably means that you kinda like the video, right? So consider giving a thumbs up, it really helps. And finally, who's the X4 for? Well, this is for everyone that has been screaming in all caps in all the forums telling people to not buy a Raspberry Pi and buy a mini PC instead. And jokes aside, the Radxa X4 is a powerful single board computer that can be used in server or desktop applications, and it dabbles in the maker slash do-yourself world. There are a lot of trade-offs between a proper mini PC, the Radxa X4, and the Raspberry Pi were another ARM SBC. If you're worried about power consumption, or if you're planning on using one of the many hats available in the Raspberry Pi system, well, the Pi 5 might be the better choice. If you want an affordable home lab with a tiny, tiny footprint, and you want to attach some sensors to it, the X4 might be the ticket. And lastly, if you're looking for PCIe expandability or building a NAS with multiple hard drives, or if you want a beefy Proxmox server, a proper mini PC with upgradable RAM might be much better suited for the task. So what do you think? I'm always interested in what other people are doing with these tiny little computers. It's crazy to me that an $80 computer can do nowadays. So leave a comment and let me know what you're working on and if you plan on getting the X4 and how you're going to be using it. And with that, I'll see you in the next one.